Oh, and thanks for joining us for this Emmy award-winning newscast. Hello, I'm Lucas McFadden.
I am still tearing, dancing here in my seat. I'm Laura Brie Monday. It is great to be here. We have a friend right here on the set with us. Our friend Emmy, very excited.
She looks so good. We love her.
We will get to that a little later, but first, preparing for the primaries. And we want to tell you about York's police chief and another officer receiving suspensions for an April car chase.
You're watching CNN News. If I had a hammer, well, you may know the rest of that song.
Well, one person with a hammer can only do so much, but hundreds of people with hammers, now that can make a world of difference. That's the idea behind Habitat for Humanity, and that's where we find our latest CN2 hometown hero.
Tessa Corbin's working hard to build her new home, but she couldn't do it alone. As the lucky recipient of one of just a few Habitat for Humanity homes being built in York County this year, it takes a team of volunteers to raise these walls, and these volunteers love being here.
Those of us on the construction committee have a real good camaraderie. We tease each other a lot, we laugh a lot, we help each other. We protect each other.
It never ceases to amaze any of us, staff or even other volunteers, the people who are willing to give up their time to come out and help another family.
Since 2009, Angie Simpson has been one of those volunteers. She shows up and then some.
When I came in, I immediately knew she is the woman. She is the one who is out there. She's motivating other females. She's working right alongside those guys. She's on our construction committee, so she walks through each week what tasks need to be completed on the home.
Her motivation is simple.
The people that I work with and knowing that there's a family that's going to benefit from it.
One, two, three, say Habitat.
Habitat!
You guys are awesome, and I have one more thing. Stay put, my friends. So I hear that y'all take a lot of volunteers to do this. No doubt about it. Agreed?
Yes.
We can't do this without volunteers. But some of our volunteers really go above and beyond. So not only are we out here today to build a fabulous home for a fabulous family, but we also want to honor our latest hometown hero. So will Miss Angie please step forward? Angie Simpson, our latest hometown hero, you go above and beyond. I hear it over and over and over again. So congratulations and thank you for all the work you do.
They are heroes for just coming out and volunteering to help. Putting their sweat into my future home.
I've got to tell you, the hand in the keys to the family is really special.
And when you look at this, ever overwhelming, or you just look at that key and you know that's the end game, so this is all worth it.
Well, sometimes it's overwhelming. But yeah, it's knowing that it's going to be done. And, you know, the last few minutes where we go, oh my God, we've got so much to do. And everybody jumps in and we get it done. And it's so special, really is special when we hand over the keys.
If we didn't have people who were willing to go above and beyond and care about other people, more so than, you know, their own selves and doing stuff that benefits them personally, I don't really know what this world would be like. So it really is inspiring to have people like Angie.
Heroes with hammers, making a difference one nail at a time.
Terrific group.
Yeah, a lot of fun out there.
It was a great time. I was out there for the women's build.
Yeah.
And she really is inspiring. She's a go-getter. We are going to get this done.
I want her to build my next project.
Habitat in York County will build about 3 homes this year, and they do work on about a dozen or more other homes in the community. They see around 900 volunteers every year, but 40 or so, like Angie, really are the core.
That's what you need, a good foundation.
You're watching CN2 News, your number one source for award-winning hometown coverage.
CN2 had great seats for the inauguration ceremony of Dr. Jamie Comstock. What made her laugh out loud during the ceremony? We'll have that story just ahead. Good evening. I'm CN2's Laura Brie Monday, thrilled to be joining you from the campus of Winthrop University. This is an institution that, of course, takes great pride in its history, and today was history in the making. When they look back, you almost think, oh, I bet a lot of them will say, we should have gone. Certainly a good crowd, though. A lot of professors, a good number of students, but we sort of wished, you know, I look around and I'm like, why aren't you inside? It's interesting. It's a student perspective, I suppose.
You know, I think as an alum now, I'm wearing my ring.
Well, thank you, Allison Rauch, for your coverage. Lucas McFadden, we're heading it back to you. I'm sorry you weren't able to sit through this because it really was very interesting hearing from her past and really looking towards the future.
Welcome back to CN2 News. Such an honor to be here on Winthrop's campus, specifically in the president's office. Beautiful space. Dr. Jamie Comstock, thank you for having us out.
Oh, you're welcome.
Representative Simrell also telling CN2 you do not have to answer the questions if you're not sure. If you would like a full list of those questions, you can visit the website right there on your screen. And of course, stay tuned to CN2 News for your primary election updates as we hit the polls Tuesday.
Rob Jones, thanks so much. It's great to be back.
We really have missed you. I know it's been a couple of weeks. I understand you've been a little busy.
Yeah, that makes you feel good, though. To be missed. So yeah. Baby girl was born June 26th, about 6'5 pounds, and she's probably a good double that now. So mama has been working on feeding that child so that she will sleep. That has been my mission. If in 12 weeks I was going to come back to work, I needed to get her sleeping, and she is doing that. That's Lila J there on the left. Ethan Tate, of course, my little boy. So he's mini me, and Lila looks a lot like dad, which is great. It rained, I think, the whole first month that she was here. It was very funny, but we're doing great.
Oh, well, you look great, and it was just good to hear Laura Bree's voice back in the studio, so we love that.
It's like riding a bike. It's good to be back.
In this next half hour, we are going to go across the gamut. Lots of great things going on here at the Y for every member of the family and for really every level of fitness.
Yeah, we're here at the Charlotte Avenue YMCA here in Rock Hill, and we're actually going to go through an exercise program that anyone watching us today can do easily, and you can do it with your own body.
You know I love our viewers. When I get into exercise gear and head to the Y, thank you, Lucas. I feel good. We want to bring over Debbie Rast. She is a terrific member of this team. It is so good to have you here.
Thank you.
So you are over the aerobics. You're over instruction. You also do personal training.
I do personal training as well.
Hold it here. Keep your chest up. Breathe. Good. Hold it. Hold it. I know you're burning. If you're burning, you can stand up and sit back down. Good. That's 2 minutes. Good. We're going to stop here.
Welcome back to CN2 News. It is always a favorite day when we have fun guests in our studio, and today in particular, we have two fun guests. This is little Maisie, of course, with Mary Beth Knapp from the Humane Society of York County.
Thanks for having us.
Bringing her by. She is being wonderfully cooperative while we sit here and chat, but we want to talk about some upcoming event that really is wonderful, so let's start there.
Awesome. I am also a Boys and Girls Club alum.
I was happy to MC the evening, which is full of music and fun. Tickets, the always popular wine pull, a silent and live auction, helping to bring in more than $40,000. The Boys and Girls Clubs of York County run three locations and serve 800 children every year. The Youth of the Year also named, and she says the club has changed her in a good way.
Willingness to change myself, because before I was so stubborn.
Also on hand, the Catawba Indian Nation, who gave a performance, and a group of students just learning to play the guitar a couple days a week there at the club. I was especially honored to be presented with an honorary membership by the club. They are such a wonderful group of folks. It was really a surprise, and I'm very appreciative. And this was what you missed by not being
there.
Oh, man,
I know.
I know, a special time. They're wonderful. So they have a copy of one of their cards on here, and it says member number one. Oh. I love that.
Well, you're a great alumni. I know you really support them, and it's a great cause.
Well,
it really
is a great group. Folks. Yeah.
What an honor, truly, to be up here. We are owned by Comporium Communications. We are a small cable company based in York County. We cover York, Lancaster, and Chester counties. We do one newscast a day, and we do an incredible job, I must say. And I am so proud of this award. Thank you, everyone, for your support.
I tell you what, I am shaking now watching it. You have 30 seconds to get everything and you want to say. So we want to thank you at home. I thank again the incredible team. We couldn't do it without you. It really is about you. It's about the story. Mm-hmm. And please know that we'll continue to do great work. We're back right after this.